is the Chicago Navy Pier.
See the sky. That does mean this boat has no cover. And if you look out there, you will see Lake Michigan. So if the water does want to get in the boat, there's not really anything standing in the way. So this is your wetness warning. For my people sitting in the back of the boat along the sides closer to the silver railing, you are in those prime splash seats. If anyone on the boat were to get wet, it would likely be you. To my people here in the front of the boat, I make y'all no promises. We could all get equally as wet. And if getting wet is an absolute deal breaker for anybody on this boat, now is the perfect time to find a nice dry seat inside Navy Pier. It's the driest place I can offer you. But we're still good. All right, second thing. I'm sure you noticed as you boarded the boat, it did rock a little bit, but it's going to bounce around a whole lot more out there on the lake. So if anybody has any medical conditions that would not like to be bounced around, like a bad neck, bad back, bad heart, osteoporosis, general bad attitude, recent surgery, or you are in the later stage of the pregnancy, this is most definitely not the place you want to be. I cannot fix any of the issues that may arise on the boat, so I ask you stay nice and safe inside Navy Pier. Okay, we're still here. Third thing, there's no smoking on the dog under any circumstances, but now let's get on our way. What did it say to stand? When we get back to the dock, everything is nice and secure. We are free to disembark. I swear we will. As we are getting out here, there are a few more things that I do need to let you know. The first one actually is about this silver railing right here. It lines the entirety of the boat, and it is there for a very good reason. You see, some people like to live life to the fullest and like to stick their hands out here and try and touch the hand. So I do ask that we try and prevent anything happening while we're here on the boat. I ask that you keep all body parts inside the boat for me at all times. Hands, feet, heads, anything else that you might want to stick outside of the boat. Please resist the urge. I promise you are not missing.
Would not like to be touched in the lake water.
But just in case you do, they are in the back of the boat for emergency use only. Your captain will let you know if you do need them. And there is a plaque in the boat telling you how to use them as well. I should also probably tell you who we are here on the dock today. I mean, I've been smoking for a minute and you don't know who I am, but I'm everybody. Welcome to the north side of Chicago. I actually want to start with something that is actually pretty cool to see, and you can really only see it at night. It's off over there to your left. All those really, really tiny lights. That actually is not Chicago. It's Indiana. You can really only see it at night. Just because the lights do make it so much easier. But I do like to point it out because I don't get to see it that often. But a few things about the city. I actually want to start with this thing that's almost directly in front of us, a little off to the left. It has those two antennas flashing red towards the sky. That is the John Hancock Center. It is currently the fourth tallest building here in the city of Chicago. It would rank in as the second tallest, but we don't actually use those antennas to count towards the height we use to record the buildings when comparing them to one another. But a little bit about the Hancock Center. At the top, actually, you can see the most interesting part. It's covered in all those windows, blue and gold looking lights. That is the signature bar and lounge. It's one of the highest rated and reviewed restaurants here in the city of Chicago. So if you are looking for a bite to eat tonight, it is a place that I can recommend with a good amount of confidence. Before you go, I feel like I should let you know that it is expensive, even by Chicago standards, which is honestly saying a whole lot. So if you do go, by all means, feel free to take your tour guide with you. Treat him to a nice meal. He'll be very thankful. I'll cover tip, maybe gas, depending on how the prices are tonight. But that's just a little bit about the Hancock Center. I also want to tell you a little bit about its outside. It actually is covered top to bottom around all four sides with these large metal X's that kind of cover the entire building. And they are there with a very specific purpose in mind. You see, those X's are actually the way the building supports itself. It doesn't have those support beams on the inside that are really that load-bearing. So it uses those X's along the outside in order to remain upright. And I thoroughly wish I knew more about supportive X's personally, but that might just be a personal issue, might just be a me thing. But that's just a little bit about the Hancock Center. On the inside, there are office spaces on the lower levels, but above that, there are condos just below the signature bar and lounge. Something else I want to talk about actually is further north of the Hancock Center. It's actually all those lights you see along the shore of the lake over here. That is actually miles and miles worth of beaches that we have here in the city of Chicago. But Chicago actually doesn't have any sand to call its own. It was actually built on a very swampy, marshy area, so sand isn't really a thing that we know much about. But Indiana and Michigan have a lot of sand. So we buy it and we ship it on over here, and it's great. But then the lake takes it right back. But that's about it for the north side of the city. And I know y'all are itching to get back to our Seadog ride, so... Everybody, how we feeling? All right, that's good to hear. Welcome to the south side of the city this time. The first thing I want to talk about, whoever said that, I'm with you. I'm from the south side of the city. Anyway, the first thing I want to talk about actually is pretty much directly in front of us. It's a building with a red and a blue antenna pointing towards the sky. Kind of looks thinner at the top and thicker towards the middle. That right there is the tallest building here in the city of Chicago, at just about 1,451 feet tall. It has 110 stories, and that is called the Sears Tower. That's when I know who's from the city of Chicago, because they get it, they get it. Now, my whole job is to tell you the truth. And the truth is that Sears is spelled W-I-L-L-I-S, and also is pronounced Willis. Mostly because currently that is called the Willis Tower. But I don't know many people in the city that will admit that it's the Willis Tower, so I'm going to continue to call it the Sears Tower. That's pretty much all you need to remember about it. But I can tell you about something at the top, the sky deck. It is an amazing way to enjoy some views of the lake and the city if you're looking for something else to do over here. I also want to point out all those lights over there. That, actually, off your left, is Soldier Field, home of the Chicago Bears. I like my Bears fans, too. Y'all getting me tonight. But there is a little rumor going around that they actually recently purchased Arlington Park, which is further north. And they plan to move Soldier Field over there. So this will soon, that's what I said when I found out. I was like, y'all doing this for real? No, but soon it will not be home of the Chicago Bears. There's something else that I want to point out while I have you over here. And it would be all those things over there. Those bright lights you see, that is actually Grant Park, where currently Lollapalooza is happening. That's what you hear, and that's what those lights are. It's a music festival held here in the city. It did look like a pretty fun lineup for tonight, because today is the last day. But that does mean that tomorrow, Grant Park will be safe for people to go to again, because it will no longer be crowded with a bunch of annoying people, and it will be possible to navigate again. And you can even go there and visit that purple thing that you see along the lakeshore. It looks like lavender color. The colors are kind of changing. That actually is Buckingham Fountain. And they have water shows every hour, but at night is personally when I think it does get a whole lot better, mostly because they add colors and lights, and it becomes a light show, and it is just that much more enjoyable. But one last thing before I let us go, actually. Over here, just in front of Soldier Field, you see a building that looks like it has a dome at the top. That is Abbott Planetarium here on the museum campus. And that actually is the first planetarium built here in the Western Hemisphere. Now, I know a few of us are from the city of Chicago, so I'm sure you realize that we don't see stars at night. So I don't know what you use a planetarium for, but they do have an exhibit going on right now called the Chicago Night, where they claim to show you what the night sky would look like if all the light pollution weren't there. So if you are wondering what the sky would look like, you know, go there and see what would be 35,000 stars in the night sky. That's just something that would suit your fancy. That also over there is the museum campus where we house the Adler Planetarium, the Field Museum, where you go visit everyone's favorite dinosaur, Sue, who we recently found out was a guy, actually. They miscounted when they were doing the bones the first time. And the Shedd Aquarium, maybe even catch an aquatic show over there. But that is about all I have to tell you about the south side of the city. So I do have to know, are you all ready to get back to a speedboat ride? All right, everybody, let's get going fast. Thank you. once again gone past the very haunted lighthouse. If you're wondering why I continue to call it the haunted lighthouse, it's because I thoroughly believe that it's haunted. You see, they actually built that house in two pieces. The house part over there, and then the part that they actually need, the tower with the light at the top, on the shore. For some reason, I don't know why they decided to separate the two. Then they had to move it to where it is now. And they may or may not have possibly crushed somebody in the process, but I did not tell you that. Now I believe that lighthouse is haunted because while it is no longer manned, it's entirely an automated process. There's a sensor in there that's supposed to detect when the sun has gone down and when there's not enough light in the sky for people to be able to see the harbor wall over there. That red light that you see should start flashing. Now, the sensor's supposed to detect daylight. So tell me why, middle of the day, 12 o'clock, sun's out, birds chirping, everybody having a good time, that lighthouse is going off. Flashing. That red light, it's real creepy. Yeah, I blame it on the ghost. Apparently it was due to the spiders though. If you're afraid of spiders, I didn't tell you that either. But that's just a little bit about it. We are now pulling up to this building, which should be familiar to all of us. It is called Navy Pier, but it did not always have the name. It used to be this place called Municipal Pier 2, and there were plans for 1 and a 3 further north and further south, but they did blow through the budget with this one right here. Now, the only part of the pier that really hasn't changed since it was built is the front. It's a ballroom, and it has always been a ballroom, which is strange because Navy Pier was built originally as a place to catch boats full of animals, and I personally would not get dressed up to go dance next to a bunch of smelly animals. That might just be a me thing. I don't know if we all can agree on that, but that's my personal view on it. It pretty much gained the name Navy Pier when the Navy used it for training purposes during the First and Second World War. And then the mayor, Daly, decided he was going to turn it into the tourist attraction you see before you today. And they even added a Ferris wheel, but not that one. The original one was called the Wheel of Death. It was like 236 feet tall. Terrible ride. Absolutely horrifying. Until they offered people drink tickets to ride it. But that's a different story for a different day. But replacing with that one right there, the Centennial Wheel. And it is an amazing way to get some views of the lake and the city on this fine evening. But with that, that is pretty much all I have to tell you about the city, so our time together is coming to a close. At this moment, you can feel free to unfasten those seatbelts, but if you wouldn't mind doing me a huge favor, can you place them behind you in your chairs before you disembark the boat? Fasten them behind your back if it's not too much trouble. It's so much easier and safer to get everyone off the boat and to disembark the boat. We need to make sure that we all get there safely. I hope you all enjoyed your time with us today, and if you did, you see a yellow normal trip advisor, by all means, feel free to mention that you went out on Lake Michigan with your captain Jamie, your first mate Eric, and me, your tour guide Eddie. We love hearing what everyone has to say about the tour, but with that, on behalf of myself, your captain Jamie, and your first mate Eric, thank you so much for riding with us. I hope you enjoy the rest of your night here at the pier and here in the city. It has been a pleasure being your tour guide. Thank you all so much.
All right, guys, give it up for your tour guide, Eddie. Show some love, folks. All right, you guys are very lucky to have Eddie today as your tour guide. It's one of the best we got at the Seadog, and he really does know a lot about the city of Chicago. So if you have any lingering questions or you just want to ask Eddie what you can do tonight in our beautiful city, feel free to do so. He'll be in the back of the boat while you are this way, and I am 100% sure that I'm in it. But you can just tell him how much you enjoyed his tour. You know, high five, a fist bump, pat on the back. Or better yet, if you're feeling generous on this beautiful Sunday night, feel free to give Eddie a couple dollars. So you remind folks of a very hardworking college student. And most of his income does come from tips, making it too easy. He's actually about to go back to school pretty soon. So I'm pretty sure I'll appreciate if you can help him pay for some books or something. So, all right, guys, at this point of boat ride, yes, you're not free to unbuckle those seatbelts. Please do us that favor. Please buckle them right back up behind you and top of your seats. Don't let it fall to the floor, tend to disparate corners. And